Hi, I'm Denise Yohn. Today's Brand Experience Brief is about Walmart's neighborhood markets, the smaller format store is part of Walmart's multifaceted strategy to maintain its retail dominance. Right now, there are about 200 neighborhood markets open, and the company plans to open more than 500 by fiscal year 2016. And with good reason. Neighborhood markets' comparable sales in the first half of 2012 were up 5%, which is double the growth rate of the Walmart U.S. average. Net margins are around 3%, and the business unit generates more than $10 billion of sales as a whole right now. A neighborhood market recently opened up in La Mesa, a suburb of San Diego, so I went to take a look. As indicated by its name, the store is primarily a supermarket, with a selection of food products and fresh produce comparable to any grocery store, and it has a pharmacy and a good-sized non-food section for household and personal care products. It's really nice, with high exposed ceilings, long wide aisles, and lots of white paint. The visual identity for the store incorporates a bright green color in place of the blue used on regular Walmarts, and the signage features bright colors and good photography. Now, whenever I visit a supermarket, the test I apply to see whether I would personally shop there is their soy milk selection, and this store didn't disappoint. It had an extensive, well-stocked selection at prices lower than what I normally pay at Ralph's, which is a Kroger-owned chain of grocery stores in Southern California. Speaking of Ralph's, the neighborhood market is in the same strip mall as a Ralph's and is going head-to-head with it. Check out this price comparison display at the front of the store claiming you save over $36 by shopping at Walmart. The other noteworthy point about the location of the stores is it is exactly 1 mile from a regular Walmart. Although the distance between the two stores is so small, the differences between them are quite big. Of course, the neighborhood market is much smaller, around 50,000 square feet, which is about a quarter the size of a typical Walmart. And it doesn't have all of the regular Walmart departments like clothing and toys. But what was most notable to me was how much fresher, cleaner, and brighter it was. Now, some of this is because the location I visited is newer, but it's also because of the design and layout, visuals, and space at the neighborhood market. It feels big and airy, and there's a lot more open space compared to those tight corners and crowded aisles you have to navigate at a regular Walmart. And there aren't any of those mid-aisle pallet displays that offer great prices but look really ugly and sometimes get in the way. From a business perspective, all of this translates into lower sales per square feet, and indeed, according to analyst reports, the neighborhood markets appear to be much less productive than other Walmart stores. But so far, the company doesn't seem to be too concerned. It knows that it will soon reach the saturation point for its big box supercenters, and smaller store formats like the neighborhood market are key to its continued growth. And the strategy is really about competing against dollar stores and grocery stores. Right now, it looks like Walmart's neighborhood markets just might win that fight.